Okay, Assalamualaikum and hello. Welcome back from mid-sem break. Okay, so today we will continue with new chapter. Okay, chapter 3, which is power system generation and transmission and distribution. Okay, so this note is already uploaded in e-learning, so you can download it. Okay, you have a lecture note. Okay, this 3 is the lecture note and this one is the textbook. Okay, you can either use textbook or lecture note. Okay, so for this week we focus on the generation. So let's have a look. Okay, so this is the new topic. Okay, generation. So if you recall back, electricity has 3 parts. Okay, if you recall back, okay, so you have the generation, okay, GEN, okay. Sorry, my pen is not working properly today. So generation and then transmission. Okay, transmission line, you have transmission line and then you have the load. Okay, this one is distribution. Okay, so basically you have a transformer here, TX. Okay, usually this one is around 11 kilovolt to 33 kilovolt depending on the generation, but this one standard 132.275500 kilovolt and kilovolt. So this is only in Malaysia. Okay, other country use different voltage. So this is the transmission line, very high voltage. Why we increase it? Because we want to reduce the current. When we reduce the current, remember P loss is equals to I squared R. So R is the resistance in the wire, okay, and I is the current in the transmission line. So when you transmit the when you increase the voltage, remember conservation of energy, okay, conservation of power. So P in equals to P out. So means that if you have, for example, 10 volt, 10 ampere, okay, in the input of the transformer, at the output, if you increase it, for example, 100 volt, the current become 1 ampere. So 1 ampere, if you look at here, the power is reduced. That's why we use transformer to increase the voltage, okay, to reduce the power losses. Okay, so at the distribution, you have another transformer. This one usually step up. Okay, and then this one is step down. Okay, so you have step down transformer in the distribution part. Usually we reduce it to in Malaysia 33 and 11 kilovolt. Okay, so at this side you can see here, this is TX. Okay, 132.275 and 500 kilovolt. Okay, and then you reduce it, for example this one maybe 33 kilovolt, you reduce it again 11 kilovolt, and then you reduce it to this one is TX, also step down transformer TX, and then this one is 415 volt or 230 volt for single phase. This one is 3 phase. Okay, this one is single phase. So this is the system in Malaysia. Okay, some industry use 33 kilovolt. Okay, so they tap here and then they use it. Okay, look, usually industry, and sometimes the industry use 11 kilovolt. Okay, so LOAD, and usually this load is usually commercial or commercial or residential. Okay, so usually residential and commercial usually use 415 or 230, but this one usually for the large industry. Okay, small industry usually also use this one. So this is called the distribution. So this is basically the electrical power system. Okay, so for this first part, we focus on this side, generation. So how to generate the power? So if you look here, we start here. Let me move this. Okay. So generation. So the objective of this topic is to list and describe the conventional and new method of electrical power generation, and then discuss configuration of two types of conventional power generation, namely steam and hydro. So we focus on the steam and hydro for this subtopic. Okay, no need to worry because we only look at the surface only. Okay, no need to worry because we only look at the surface. Okay, so the third objective is to calculate the parameters and performance related to electrical generation. So you have a simple calculation based on the steam and hydro. Okay, so we look at the introduction. Generation of electrical energy is the first process in delivering power to customer. Okay, so this one I think already most of you already understand. So this is the first step, the generation. And then electrical energy can be categorized as a commodity that undergoes production process similar to that clothes and food. Okay, so basically electrical generation is basically some kind of process. Okay, electrical generation is also involved a process of converting various non-electrical energy such as mechanical, chemical and into electrical. So basically you have a multiple type of energy. Okay, so let me adjust this. Okay, okay, so basically your process of generation, okay, electrical generation, so basically you have output, of course you have electrical energy. Okay, so you have multiple system. Okay, so either it can be from mechanical, okay, mechanical energy, okay, maybe rotation, okay, or you can have a heat energy, okay, or any other type of chemical energy, for example, okay, or even nuclear energy. So basically you just convert all of this into electrical. Okay, so for example solar, you convert power from sun to the electrical. Okay, and for wind turbine, usually we use the wind to produce the mechanical energy and rotating the turbine and then produce the electrical energy. So usually we only have one, not all. You cannot just combine everything into one. Usually we convert it into, for example, nuclear here. Okay, nuclear energy into heat energy into mechanical, and then electrical. So this one usually continuous. Okay, so I give you example nuclear energy. Okay, you have the conversion process, and then you have heat energy. And then another, you convert the heat energy into mechanical energy. Okay, and then lastly, from mechanical, you have a turbine. You convert mechanical energy into electrical energy. Okay, so basically all of this is a process. So this one, turbine. Okay, this one is the, if not mistaken, is the steam. Okay, I forget the name. Okay, so this one either nuclear fusion or fission. Okay, nuclear energy can be either fusion or fission. So fusion is you fuse together. Okay, combine. Usually the you use hydrogen. Okay, you fuse hydrogen together to become Okay, one. Okay, this one is the fusion. Okay. If you use uranium, okay, you use fission. Okay, fission is basically split the atom. Okay, so it's something like that. So basically, it's just a process. Okay, and the main difference in electrical energy production compared to other commodity is that electrical must be produced based on immediate demand. Okay, what it means that, okay, for example, what is this sentence means that, okay, let me have it, okay, for example, you have this one, generation, okay, you have generation, this one is the load, okay, you have the load, for example, the load 130 megawatt. So the generation needs to produce 30 megawatt instantly. Okay, it's basically on demand. Okay, so you cannot, you must be immediate demand. So basically, suddenly, for example, the load increase to maybe 40 megawatt. So the generation needs to produce 40 megawatt. Okay, you cannot just leave it. Okay, if you leave the system, for example, for example, the load required 50 megawatt, but the generation only produced 20 megawatt. Okay, so basically, when this happen, all the system will be disrupted. Okay, this one will be shut down because the generation cannot cater the load. Okay, because the load demand is very high, but the generation is very low. So this one needs to occur instantaneously. Okay, so make sure you know this characteristic. So the main difference is electrical energy production compared to other commodity is that electrical must be produced based on immediate demand. Okay, if load is increased, you have to produce the energy quickly. Okay, if you don't cater it, the system will disrupt it. Okay, so the energy must be processed and transmit at an instant it required by the transformer. Okay, if the customer need it, you need to produce it. Since the electrical supply and demand process is almost instantaneous, the electrical generation requires complicated technical and economic approach. Okay, the demand, okay, the generation and demand is very complicated because you have to predict. Okay, you have to predict if the load needs how much the generation need to produce it. Okay, it's very complicated system. Okay. Okay, electrical energy is generated by converting non-electrical energy into a suitable electrical energy. This one I already explained before in here. Okay, something like this. Okay, basically you have non-electrical energy, then you have to convert it into electrical energy. Okay. Okay, there are two types of energy conversion process. Okay, it's either generation of the mechanical energy into rotate electrical generator. Okay, or direct conversion of non-electrical energy with the aid of energy storage such as battery. Okay, so you have two types. Okay, the generation can be either two types. So let me draw this, maybe you can see it more clearly. Okay, so you have two conversion process, either mechanical to electrical generator. So basically you have a mechanical energy rotate the generator. Okay, so mechanical energy can come from many form. Okay, like I showed before, nuclear energy. Okay, so basically nuclear energy convert into heat, and then after heat it will produce a mechanical energy. Okay, the heat will produce steam and move the turbine. okay, electrical turbine or electrical generator, and then produce heat. Okay, or another example is the wind. Okay, if you have wind energy, okay, wind energy will rotate the turbine. Okay, the turbine is connected to the electrical generator. Okay, the mechanical energy from the wind, okay, will produce the electric. Okay, so basically this one can be considered as one system. Okay, even hydro. Okay, for example, hydro, you have a water. Okay, that you have dam. Okay, the water is very, a lot of water will be moving the turbine, which is mechanical energy. Okay, from the potential energy converted into the mechanical energy, rotating the turbine, and then producing the electricity. So basically this is the first conversion process. It's basically just rotating the electrical generator. Okay, the second one is direct conversion. So direct conversion doesn't involve any electrical generator. So this one is basically electrical generator. Okay, another one is the non-electrical energy with the aid of energy storage, direct conversion. So there is no electrical generator. So for this one is battery. Okay, for example here, battery should be something like this. This is the symbol. So battery, okay, this one is chemical. Okay, and chemical into electric. Okay, so basically it doesn't use electrical generator. So basically from chemical energy into electrical energy. Okay, this one, another one is solar. Okay, let me, so solar, this one out of topic actually. So solar is, the symbol is this. Okay, so solar is basically irradiant from the sun. Okay, you have irradiant from the sun, goes into the PV. Okay, energy from the sun energy, then directly convert into electrical energy. So this is generation using PV. So basically you don't use electrical generator. Okay, or another example is thermoelectric generator or TEG. Okay, so you have heat energy. Okay, you have heat energy. Okay, you just directly convert into electrical. Okay, from heat energy convert into electrical energy. You don't use any generator. So basically you have two category, either using a electrical generator or direct conversion. So you need to know the difference. Okay, the technique commonly utilized for generation of mechanical energy to rotate electrical energy are, okay, so basically what it says is that, okay, let me draw this. Okay, conversion process. Okay, conversion process, you have electrical generator or direct conversion. Okay, you have two, right, before. So right now electrical generator, you have another category from the electrical generator, either using heat or steam. Okay, so what it means that heat or steam, this method is basically involved either burning a suitable fuel resources or activating nuclear reaction to produce heat. Okay, the heat is subsequently used to turn the water into dry a high pressure steam. Okay, the heat convert into a steam, very high pressure steam, which become the mechanical energy source to move the turbine and generator shaft. Okay, so basically electrical generator, okay, let me make it bigger. Okay, so if you recall back kettle, I think, I'm not sure whether you know kettle or not, because right now there are a lot of water filter. Maybe you don't see kettle, but if you know what is kettle, okay, so you have a kettle here. It's something like this. Okay, so you have a handle here. Okay, when you apply heat into the kettle, okay, this is the water. Okay, you have water here. Okay, when you heat it, okay, when it reach 100, the water, okay, liquid turns into gas. Okay, this gas move here. Okay, at the very small opening, it will produce steam. Okay, very high pressure. If you have a kettle, you can see here very fast moving gas. Okay, water gas. Okay, water in the form of gas. So basically, when you heat water, okay, it will produce gas, and this gas is very high, and then you just put the turbine. Okay, it's very hard to draw the turbine. And so basically something like a fan. Okay, so something like this, something like this. Okay, the high steam, high pressure steam can move this turbine, and then you connect the turbine into generator, electrical generator, and it will produce the electric energy. Okay, but for this one is just example. Basically, you don't use kettle. Okay, you use a very large, okay, large burner. Okay, a very large burner, not a kettle. Okay, this large burner. Okay, I will show you after this. So basically, you converting the heat energy. Okay, heat. You burn anything. Okay, for example, the coal. Okay, maybe the gas. Okay, it will produce heat. The heat will make the water goes into the steam. Okay, and the steam will move the turbine. So this is one of the way to move the electrical generator. So next, okay, so let me show you what is the material that can produce the heat. Okay, so this one is standard, the coal. Okay, because it is very cheap. Okay, coal is very cheap. Okay, actually abundant, actually, although the coal is quite abundant, that's why it's quite cheap. So most people use coal as a energy generation. And then you have a petroleum, hydrocarbon oil, of course. Okay, and then you have a natural gas. Okay, and then of course you have the nuclear. Okay, nuclear, basically nuclear energy, you as I mentioned before, fission. Basically you split the atom. Okay, from uranium. Okay, uranium have one is one material. Okay, you split it into two, and then it will release a very high amount of energy, heat energy, and then this heat energy will be will heat up the water and produce steam and move the wind, move the electrical turbine. Okay, deuterium also nuclear, also useful. Okay, deuterium is basically hydrogen. Okay, this one is I forget the name, but it's basically a hydrogen. Okay, hydrogen, there are three if not mistaken. Okay, deuterium. Okay, basically if you increase the pressure, okay, increase the pressure, and heat it up, okay, it will fuse, the hydrogen will fuse together, and it will produce a energy. Okay, so basically this is a one of the system, as I mentioned before. Basically use heat to produce steam, rotate the generator. Okay. Okay, now we move on to the next part, generation of mechanical energy directly from the source. Okay, so electrical generator, you also have direct mechanical. Direct mechanical energy. So electrical generator, either you can use heat or direct mechanical energy. Okay, make sure you know the difference. Okay, so you can see here, it used a stored kinetic energy readily available used to develop mechanical energy source of electricity. So basically it used kinetic energy that is available. So this one, of course, hydro, okay, water, okay, hydro energy. Geothermal also, okay, high pressure. This one is basically the earth heat up the energy, and then wind energy, basically directly The wind produce the mechanical energy directly without producing heat. Okay, and then wave also. Okay, the wave from the sea. Okay, can generate the energy. So that is how you generate energy. Okay, directly. Okay, mechanical energy directly from the source. Okay. In direct conversion of the non-mechanical energy into electrical energy, there are natural resources that can be used to generate. Okay, so this one is basically, okay, it explains this one. Okay, direct conversion. Okay, we already complete the electrical generator. Now we go to the direct conversion. So direct conversion, you can see here solar energy. I already explained it to you. Okay, solar energy is basically you have a okay, you have to be careful. Solar, you have two types. Okay, so you need to be careful. Okay, you have a solar here. It's actually not solar. It's PV, photovoltaic. P H O T O V O T A I C. Okay, photovoltaic conversion. Okay. But for this course, don't need to worry. If you write it solar energy, I also accept it. Okay, but it's actually photovoltaic. So photovoltaic, the one that I show you, this one, just convert electrical the solar energy into electrical energy. Okay, so this one is direct conversion. So be careful, this one, okay, no need to worry, this one actually is a little bit out of your syllabus. But some of the solar energy, okay, for example, solar energy used to heat up water, okay, using a mirror, okay, you use mirror, okay, focusing the solar energy. Okay, heat up the water and then you generate the turbine. Okay, this one, I think, okay, is out of your topic. No need to worry. Okay, so this is just a knowledge you should know. Okay, in the generation system. Okay, but for this class, you just put the solar energy into the direct conversion. Okay, another one is fuel cell. So fuel cell is basically hydrogen. Okay. You put a hydrogen into a fuel cell, okay, and then it will directly convert it into electrical energy. You can read about it more, or you can watch in YouTube what is fuel cell. Okay, it is a renewable energy. You can watch it. Okay. So next, electrical generation station have mechanical machine that function to convert the raw materials such as coal, gas, water, etc. to mechanical energy. The energy used to power the synchronized generator, which is the main component of the electrical system. So for this one, most of it already explained, but there is a new information, which is synchronized generator. Okay, so this one is actually topic 4, I think. Okay, topic 4 in machine. Okay, generator. Okay, generator, you have three types. Okay, either you have DC, okay, DC generator, you have induction, okay, and you have a synchronized generator. Okay, so you can see here, it said that synchronized generator. Why? Because synchronized generator, you can control the speed easily. Okay, so because you remember that in Malaysia we use 50 hertz. Okay, we use 50 hertz. So because we want to control the speed, okay, this one is basically the speed of the rotation generator. Okay, so we want to rotate the generator 50 times, okay, 50 times second, something like that. Okay, it is much more complicated than that. Okay, so basically something like this. Okay, we want to maintain the speed, okay, of the generator. So synchronized generator is the good choice, okay, because it can control speed. Induction is very simple, very robust, but the problem with the induction motor is hard to control the speed, okay. And DC is not very robust because you have to change the brush, okay. For this one, no need to worry. So basically, you have to focus on the synchronized generator. You need to know that the conversion of electrical energy is usually we use synchronized generator. Okay, that is the important point that is shown here. Okay, so this one I mentioned before, you have mechanical energy, you have the rotating, okay, of a generator shelf. Okay, you have the synchronized generator. Make sure you know the name, synchronized generator. Okay, convert the mechanical energy into electrical energy and then generate a voltage at the terminal, okay, to produce the electrical energy. Okay, so mechanical energy produce torque to rotate the generator shaft. Okay, the shaft rotate enable flux from the rotation structure to cut the conductor and then at the stationary part of the generator, which produce an electrical source in the form of generated voltage at the terminal line. So you have to recall back the what you have learned in the magnetic circuit. Okay, if you cut the flux, okay, let me draw this for you. Okay, okay, so you have a you have a north, okay, you have a south, you have a magnetic flux here, okay, something like that, north to south, of course, okay, magnetic flux, and you have a conductor, okay, conductor, okay, you have a conductor move perpendicular to the this one, okay, for example like this, okay, this one, the wire goes into, I think. Okay, this one, if not mistaken, you use right hand rule. Okay, so basically when you move the conductor here, move it here, okay, the current will produce, okay, the magnetomotive force will be produced. Okay, that is how the generator work. Okay, so generator is basically you move this. Okay, basically the shaft just move the conductor into the magnetic flux. Okay, so this is just a simple, but in actual synchronous generator is very complicated. Okay, but the concept is the same. Basically, you have a conductor, you just move into the magnetic field, and the current will be produced, or magnetic EMF, electromotive force. Okay, basically at the result, you have produced the voltage at the terminal. That is how you generate the energy, electrical energy. Okay, so this one is thermal, okay, thermal power station. So this one I will talk about this thermal power station in the next video. Okay, I split the video first. Okay, so see you again after this. Okay, make sure you check in your attendance in the e-learning. Okay, if I have time tomorrow, I will place the attendance in, if I have time, I will place the attendance in the e-learning. Okay, sorry about that. I have to record for this session. Okay, so don't forget to check in your attendance. Okay, see you again.